Hi everyone, this is Rohan Jain. A quick introduction. I did my B.Tech in computer science from IIT Kanpur. I graduated in 2015. During my B.Tech, I realized that I was more interested towards management. I explored this interest by pursuing a few MBA courses at IIT Kanpur, which I really liked. I took CAT during my final year at IIT Kanpur, and I got calls from all the top IIMs.
We see you have a very good academic record.
Thank you, sir.
Why do you want to leave computer science?
So I don't think I'm leaving computer science. I feel I'll be able to use my skills and take it further in the management environment. I also wish to pursue consulting after my MBA. Computer science has basically taught me to think in a very structural manner. And I think that will be really helpful in MBA as well as my consulting.
I see. When did you realize your interest in management?
During my B.Tech, I actually decided to explore my interests and decided to go for internships for both computer science and management. So for computer science, I went to EPFL Switzerland, and for management, I went to LBS, London Business School. And there, after talking to a lot of management trainees and management students, I realized that my inclination is towards management.
This was like an exercise in self-discovery.
Yes.
What were the internships about?
So the EPFL internship was more about cloud computing. I had to automate their cloud computing using Python. And the internship at LBS was more on operations. So I had to design a simulation for one of their major operations project.
Enough of academics. How do you pass your free time?
I am a badminton player. I have also represented my college for various sports events.
So did you go for the inter in IIT?
Guwahati, yes. And we also won silver there.
And what happened to the IIT Mumbai this year?
I was not able to attend that because I was interning in London. But we won a gold there too.
Oh yes, right.
So tell me, Rohan, any other hobbies?
I'm an avid book reader. I like reading fictional novels.
Mm-hmm. Harry Potter.
It sounds childish, but yeah, Harry Potter is one of my favorite novels.
At least you're frank about it.
In fact, when I went to London, I went to all the places that are depicted in the book, you know, and I also went to King's Cross Station, and they have actually left a place after platform number 9 for 9¾.
Interesting.
Interesting. Any favorite characters in Harry Potter?
Yeah, I like Professor Snape.
Not Dumbledore. He's the favorite of everybody.
Not for me, definitely.
And not Hermione for you. Anyway, so tell me, any other books that you're fond of?
Yeah, I also like The Kite Runner by Khalid
Hussain.
Right. I think the father-son relationship, the bond that was depicted there is just beautiful. I also like Lord of the Rings trilogy.
In today's world of technology, and I mean, since you talked about relationships, emotions, fantasies, don't you think that as a human race, we're getting more and more devoid of emotions? You know, people are all the time on their gadgets. Do you think that technology is doing more harm than good?
So I beg to differ here. Okay. I don't think technology is doing more harm than good.
Okay.
I feel the problem that you mentioned can be solved by introducing more outdoor activities at the college and school levels.
But don't you think that at the rate at which we, the human race, is going, in 100 years of time, we'll all become like robots?
True, sir. But let me give you an example. Like in IIT Kanpur, we had a compulsory sports activity program in the first year. It was compulsory for all the students. And I think if something like this can be implemented in other schools and colleges, I think it might solve some purpose.
What do you think is the role of the computer science graduate in the progress of the nation?
I think we need more and more computer science students in India today, because with the massive boom in e-commerce and other traditional areas, and especially with our present government's Digital India initiative, we need more computer science graduates, definitely.
Fair enough. What is the Digital India initiative?
So the Digital India initiative is basically to connect the country. Basically, wherever you are, however you are placed, you can access your files, you can access your work, and etc. So this can be achieved through cloud computing, and it's some companies have already started initiating towards that, like Internet of the Things.
Yeah, Internet of Things. Yeah. Can you give some real examples of cloud computing?
Cloud computing involves a lot of remote servers that has to be...
No. My friend, I didn't ask you for the technology of it. I asked you what are the real companies using cloud computing.
Oh, okay. So, the basic examples are Google and Amazon, and there are a lot more.
Okay. All right, Rohan. I think. So, thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
We'll let you know.
Thank you.
You could have some cookie.
Thank you.
Take a toffee as well.
Thank you.
Yeah, cashew?
No, sir, I'm good. Thank you.
Thank you. You just saw the enactment of my IIM Ahmedabad interview by the RU Buzzing team. I gave the interviews of IIM A, B, C, K and L and I converted all five of them. I decided to join IIM Ahmedabad and I had an excellent time there. A few words of advice about interview preparation. When you talk about MBA interviews, there are typically three aspects that you need to cover during your preparation. The first aspect would be the technical part of the interview, which would focus on your previous course of study or your previous work experience. So you should just brush up your concepts related to your bachelor's study or concepts related to your work experience before the interview. The second aspect of the interview typically focuses on the soft part of your personality. So they would, though the panelists would ask you questions related to your personality, such as your strengths, your weaknesses, your leadership qualities, why do you want to pursue management, and similar questions. The third part of the interview is typically questions related to current affairs. The panelists expect you to read newspapers every day, so just try to read at least one or two newspapers every day before your interview to prepare for current affairs. So that's about it. If you have any further questions, you can message me on Quora. I'm very active on Quora and I try to reply to as many messages as I can. So I'll definitely try to reply to your message as well. A few words about the RU Buzzing team. I think they are doing a great job. I really love their videos. So if you love their videos as well, please like, comment, share and subscribe their channel. Thank you. All the best. Thank you.